Well, our friends from OodleBoxTV.com, the experts, are here today with another wonderful idea. Jill Slater, you're a florist, mm-hmm. and today we're talking about some interesting ways to do dried flowers.
That's right.
Which, when I was growing up, we used to call fake flowers, but I bet we don't call it that anymore.
Now they're dried flowers.
Okay. They're a lot nicer.
They're really pretty. It's the perfect time of year to dry flowers because it's hot. We're going to be making this dried swag that you can put on your front door. It's a great welcoming to your guests and your family. This is what a lot of those flowers look like fresh. Now let me show you how you dry your flowers at home. It's really easy. Come on over here. What you do is you take about 3 to 6 flowers, and I've removed a lot of the greenery off the flowers. They serve no purpose. You hang them upside down, just like I'm doing here, or maybe you have a drying rack at home, maybe the in your garage. It's very, very hot. And that's really a key to drying flowers. You want to make it very, very hot, and then you want to get the humidity out, and the humidity is created by the flowers drying. So in the morning, open your garage door, let the humidity out.
I see you have an arrangement of flowers here. Are some flowers better than others to dry?
There are better flowers to dry than others, and you really just have to be familiar with that, and we have that on our website, OodleBoxTV.com, as to what flowers dry properly. Coxcomb, sunflowers, red and pink roses dry nicely, yarrow, safflower is going to be coming into the marketplace. You might have it growing in your mm-hmm. garden. And this is eucalyptus, and I love this bear grass. That all dries very nicely.
So are you thinking like for people who maybe got a big bouquet and they want to do something with those flowers, or is this like you go out and you buy the flowers specifically for doing this?
You know, really, either will work. Just look on the website to see what dries nicely. It takes about a week or so to dry most flowers.
So we have our flowers already dried
and
ready to go.
So simple to do. I have about 3 to 5 flowers of each variety. This is eucalyptus. I put it in a bunch. I put the coxcomb on top of it. The euke is longer than the coxcomb. Next comes the yarrow. It's shorter than the coxcomb. You see, I'm just stacking it. Mm-hmm. And then this is called straw flower, cut shorter than the rest, stacking it again. And the red roses. So, how easy could this be? What you do is you need a big hand and a large rubber band. And we're just going to rubber band these all together like this. How simple? Then take a decorative ribbon or raffia, whatever you like, whatever matches your decor, and go ahead and tie it in a bow, just like you would tie your shoe. It is so easy, but you do want to probably dry your flowers first. And as I said before, it is critical that you have a very hot environment and you let that humidity out.
Now, did you say let them dry for about a week?
About a week. You know when a rose is dry because the little bulb below the rose is hard. And you know when a lot of other flowers are dry because they sound and they feel crispy. And then these, you just kind of can tell that this is very dried compared to, look at how it is fresh.
Right? Now, what I smell, is that the fresh flowers?
You know what?
Because it smells wonderful,
it
actually.
It does smell wonderful. It's just sort of this weird smell that is created when flowers dry in the sun. Hydrangea. We all have hydrangea in our gardens. They're so beautiful. If you want to dry hydrangeas very quickly, you don't want to do this too often. Put them in your car window for a day.
Oh, really?
And it almost dries overnight.
Great tip.
But it doesn't smell good. Jill Slater's tips are all going to be at KCRA.com. We'll put a link to OodleBoxTV.com. And also, OodleBox, you guys are accepting viewers' tips as well, where you can upload a video a la YouTube, and perhaps your tip will appear on the website as well.
That's right. And if you have any flower suggestions or questions, please bring it on.
Pass them along. All right. Hey, thanks, Jill. Those were great tips. We appreciate it. Well-